In this video, you will learn what are the variables in Python and how to use them efficiently. Variables are one of the fundamental concepts in Python programming, so learning them is essential for every Python developer. Hi, my name is Adam and this is the Fakimbo, the place where we teach how to build IT career smart way so you can live the life you want. And by the way, if you want to become the highest paid software developer, click the subscribe button and turn on the notification bell so you will not miss any of IT career advice videos that we will post on this channel. Now, let's get back to our topic. Variable is a name assigned to value. For example, to create a variable and assign a string to it, we will write variable name first, equal sign, and the string. This will create a variable named foo with the string value bar, if it doesn't exist yet. If the foo already exists, its value will change to bar. We can assign value from one variable to another by doing simple assignment, for example, like this. This will assign the value from variable foo to the variable bar. Of course, we can assign any other values as well, like for example, integers, floats, or objects. It doesn't matter really. And we'll talk more about objects and object-oriented programming in Python later during this course. After we assign value to the variable, we can use it instead of value directly. So we can do something like that. Foo variable assignment string hello world. And now we can call function print that we used to call using just a string value like this. Hello world. We can use variable here directly. And when we execute it, you will see that the hello world is printed here as well. So the result is the same, but we parameterize this function using variable rather than value directly. In practice, we can use variables anywhere we would normally use values. So for example, we can have string like this hello and another string bar, which has value this. We can concatenate this string and create new string. Let's maybe call it con. And we can concatenate these two strings by just using variables instead of values directly. So it will work. And it works the same way as in any other programming languages. The variables works exactly the same. The concept is the same, no matter what programming language we are using. The variables are just here to store the values. So we can use them without referring to particular value. We can refer to the variable that can have different values at a time. At this point, it's worth mentioning that in Python, every operator, like for example, plus operator used to concatenate two strings, have its assigned version as well. So if we, for example, here want to append string from the variable bar to variable foo, we would normally write something like that. And afterwards, the value in a variable foo would be hello world, which is concatenation of these two strings. When we run it, you will see that it produces hello world. But instead of writing this, we can actually make it shorter by changing the operator from equals to plus equals and remove this part. Save it and run it. And as you see, it produces exactly the same result. So we can create shorter versions of expressions by using assignment and operator together to make shorter expressions like this one here. And we can find assignment version of any kind of operator we want. For numbers, it can be, for example, when we have a variable foo, that store number, something like that, and another variable that store another number. We can do things like minus equals foo minus equals bar, or foo multiply equals bar, or divide, or floor division, or exponent assignment. Any of these are legitimate assignment operators that that perform this operation in before the process of assignment. We can also do the same with bytewise operators, like for example one here, or like this, or this, etc. There is specific convention that applies to variable names in Python. The variable name should be lowercase with words separated by underscores. For example, the variable something like this: hello world official is a proper variable name. And this type of case, this kind of naming is called sneak case. In Python, there are no restrictions about length of variable names, but as official guideline says, the single line of code should have maximum of 79 characters. Moreover, writing longer lines breaks principle of good Python programming written in the Zen of Python, which is, by the way, worth getting familiar with. So while you create new variable name, use the common sense and try to create variable name as short as possible, but meaningful enough. Also, while crafting variable names, avoid using Python reserved keywords like class, def, else, if, pass, rise, and so on. For complete list of Python reserved keywords, visit a link on the screen. You can still use these keywords as a part of variable name, but don't use them as an entire variable name. It will be illegal, and Python interpreter will raise an exception when it will see something like that. Some of the variables are meant to have a value that is constant. Their value wouldn't change while application is running. We call this variable constants. And to distinguish them from the regular variables, we name them using uppercase. For example, we can have constant variable like max clients equals some number, or app ID with some string here. And so on. It's worth to mention that Python itself wouldn't stop us from changing the value of constant variable. Python, more than any other programming language, rely on our consistency of using convention to prevent bad things from happening. So if we are seeing variable that has a name which is uppercase, we just have to be aware that this is constant variable and we may not change its value. So this is how the variables in Python works and how you can use them. If you like this video, please give it a like so more people can find it. If you have any questions, leave the comment below, and if you want to give me any feedback, leave the comment as well, so further videos may be even better. If you want to learn Python fast, check out my free complete Python developer crash course on this channel. The ideal next step for you is to learn Python operations on strings and Python complex data types. Just follow the links on the screen. Thanks for watching and see you in the next one.